way we tell the angels always be on watch, but you yourself got to be on watch, amen? You got to watch and pray, amen? Instead of talking about people who need deliverance, go out, pray for their people who need to be delivered, amen? Right. Amen, glory be to God. You know, it's time out for us being judges, because the Bible says, judge not lest ye be judged, amen? Right. We can't judge people, but what we are supposed to do, we are supposed to use the Holy Ghost that's on the inside of us.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. To bring bring people to the knowledge and the witness and the will that God loves them. Amen. What did it say? For God so what? Loved the world that he what? Gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever what? Believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Amen. We got to have joy on the inside of us. Hallelujah. God woke you up this morning, did he not? Amen. When you looked across and your family members, they were still there. They're still alive. Amen. Even though we have our little aches and pains, God is still in the saving business. Amen. He's still in the healing business. He's still in the delivering business. Amen. Glory be to God. Let me, I'm getting away from my word already. Amen. Glory be to God. But you know, I thought about missionary, and when I looked it up in the dictionary, a missionary is saying a person who is sent into a newly settled former or a region to carry out religion. To carry out religion. That's why you were saved. To carry out religion. Amen? And what I want to say, if we really want to, if you want a title that to connect this to, I'm even in it, you're reaching out beyond yourself. Reaching out beyond ourselves.
Amen.
If nothing else, if that doesn't get your, that doesn't get to your heart, and that is it, inviting those who cannot invite you back. You got to do that sometimes. You got to invite folk who can't invite you back. Amen? And see, the primary focus of each small group or house church or small church or congregation should be outreach and discipleship. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. You're going to have to talk with me because I like to hear people talk. Amen? Amen. Rather than just fellowship, we got to be in fellowship all the time. Amen. Everywhere we go, all at the same time. Amen. Take a minute. Amen. I go to Walmart. My wife says, what you getting? You're going to go. You're going to be there. I'm going to be there for a while because I see people that need God to be in their lives. Amen. And I need to tell them. I need them to know that I am a child of God. Amen. When I hear people in the stores and I hear people on my job say, Reverend Cherry, now excuse me, I apologize in that. They're reverence my God and my Savior, Lord Jesus. Am I right about it?
Amen.
Amen. If they don't know you a child of God, you need to change your perspective a little bit. Am I right about it? Hallelujah. Then when we understand fellowship and discipleship, then we'll be a healthy but by byproduct of a small group of constant reaching out to other people. We need to reach out to other people. We got to be a byproduct of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Amen. Hallelujah. There will be much prayer and interaction within a group to meet needs of a relationship with this world. But the top priority must always be to bring in those who have not yet decided to believe in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
We gotta want to bring them in. Amen? And you know, sometimes you can't worry how they're dressed.
Amen.
Amen. You can't worry if they smell a little bit. You can't worry about that. And sometimes you gotta go pick them up yourself.
Amen.
Amen. You've been in church all your life and you walk past somebody, you ought to ask them, hey, do you need a ride to church?
Amen.
Huh? That's what a mission is about. That's what a church is about. A church is about a people who are called by my name, that humble themselves and pray and seek his face, and they turn from their wicked ways, but somebody else.
Amen.
What good is your salvation if you don't reach out to somebody?
Amen.
What good is your salvation getting to heaven if you can't say, you can't look in and the Lord say, well done, my good and faithful servant. What is a servant?
Yes, Lord.
He's a missionary. He's on a mission. Hallelujah. The primary focus is reaching out beyond ourselves. Amen. Amen. And this caused any group to mature and multiply or reproduce another small group.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. That's why there's so many house churches going on now. Amen. People aren't able to go to church, and so they're opening up the houses now. And people are going to the house, and they're sitting down with them, and they're having fellowship. And we as a body of Christ should not be angered and when we see a house church go up.
Amen.
And because, see, they're doing the same work we're doing. But we got to quit hiding behind the walls of the cathedral and get out there and do the work of the ministry.
Yes, Lord.
Am I right about it?
Amen.
I don't know about you, but until the day I die, I'm going to be a preacher in the pulpit and out on the street.
Yes.
I'm going to be a preacher when I go to my job at night. I'm going to be a preacher when I go to the mall that day. I'm going to be a preacher when I'm even sitting and when I go to the bathroom in the men's room. And if somebody wants to know Christ, I'm going to preach the gospel.
All right.
Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I know I'm crazy. You may think I'm crazy. But I serve a God that is sitting up high and looking down low.
Amen.
I want to do the work of Christ Jesus as my Savior. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. It gives more believers the opportunity to use the gifts of the Lord as given them to reach pre-Christians and make new discipleship. And I want to invite those who cannot invite themselves. Amen. And how many know there's people that can't invite themselves? Huh? You got to invite them. Because they can't invite themselves. And guess what? You know there's people that you can invite that can't invite you back.
Amen.
Hallelujah. They don't know how to call. They don't know how to invite you back. All they know is when they get around you, they feel a little different. Amen. Do people tell you that they feel a little different when they're around you? Hallelujah. You see, the whole thing is, it isn't about you anymore. It's about our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. And if you haven't seen it, sometime I scared my mother-in-law, who's living with us right now, and then I turn on the movie, The Passion of Christ. How many seen that movie? How many seen Passion of Christ? If you haven't seen it, you need to see it. You need to know what your Lord and Savior is going through. Amen. Because he went through a lot for you. And we're sitting here, taking all the benefits of his mercy and his grace.
Amen.
We're taking all the benefits of the beating that he took upon himself and the blood he shed for us all over this earth in order for us to have a right to the tree of life.
That's right.
Woo! Lord.